Hello everyone, me Gurpreet Singh on this side welcomes you all to watch a latest and new video of a very interesting chapter, that is quadratic equations. We have completed our chapter, that is polynomials of 9th class, in the previous videos, and we will be starting with our very new chapter of 10th class, that is quadratic equations. Firstly, we will discuss the basic concepts of quadratic equations, and then we will be moving to examples, right? So what are quadratic equations? Now most of you know that what is a quadratic polynomial. The polynomial whose highest degree is 2, that is a quadratic polynomial, right? For example, x square plus 2, this is a quadratic polynomial, right? Now the thing is, what does a quadratic equation look like? So firstly, we'll do the general form of a quadratic equation. So general form will be equal to ax square plus bx plus c, right? There is one condition for this equation to be a quadratic equation, that is a must not be equal to 0, right? So now if we want to write this polynomial as a quadratic equation, what we will do, we will write x square plus 2 is equals to 0. Now this has become a quadratic equation. Now you must be wondering that here is no term like bx, so we can write as 0x. We cannot write 0x square, but we can write 0x, right? So this is the general form of a quadratic equation. It was a quadratic polynomial which is transformed into a quadratic equation. So all in all, the equation of this form, whose highest degree is 2 and all of these terms are present and which will be equal to 0, is known as a quadratic equation. So we'll be discussing some of the situations in which we have to build, in which we have to form a quadratic equation first, and then we'll be doing the methods to find the solution of a quadratic equation and so on. So without wasting any time, let's start with our methods. Now this is the very first example of our exercise 4.1. In this, a situation is given and we have to convert it into a quadratic equation. First of all, John and Janvi had 45 marbles in total. So they both have 45 marbles in total. Let John had marbles is equals to x, and then automatically the marbles Janvi is having 45 minus x, because when you will add x and 45 minus x, what you will get? 45. This is what total number of marbles is given. Alright, so John and Janvi had x and 45 minus x marbles, but the thing is, they have lost 5 each. It means John has now marbles of x minus 5, but Janvi is having marbles equal to 45 minus x minus 5. So 45 minus 5, that is 40 minus x. So this is the final number of marbles that both of them are having. Product of remaining marbles is 24. It's also given. So remaining marbles, this is first and this is second. It is given that product of remaining marbles is equal to 124. What does it mean? 40x minus x square minus 200 plus 5x is equals to 124. 40x minus x square minus 200 plus 5x minus 124 is equals to 0. Now why I have done this step? Because we need 0 on our right hand side. Alright, so 40x, we will take minus x square forward, minus x square, then 40 plus 5, that is 45x, alright, and then minus 200 minus 124, it's minus 324 is equals to 0. Now we can take minus as a common factor. What you will get? X square minus 45x plus of 324 is equals to 0. Now we would like to find x. So to find x, we needed an equation and we have formed a quadratic equation. This is our answer. Don't think that you have to solve this equation as well. They have just said that they want to make an equation through which they can find the number of marbles with both of them started. Okay. So that is why this is our final equation, final quadratic equation, and you don't have to do anything further. So there is second part of this example as well. Let's see what situation is given in that example and let's make another quadratic equation. In our second part of first example, it's given that a cottage industry produces toys. Cost of production is 55 minus the number of toys produced. It means the number of toys is that term which is to be found, right? So let number of toys is equals to x. Now whenever you see any sum like this statement, just read the statement in small sections or parts to understand it in a better way. We have only read till this and we will write our terms related to the information given till this point only. Cost is 55 minus number of toys. So the cost is 55 minus x, right? Alright, the cost of toys is 55 minus x. It's given. The next information is on one particular day the total production cost was 750 rupees. Total cost on one day was 750 rupees, right? What do we have to find? We have to find the number of toys produced on that particular day. So total cost is this, but also total cost is x multiply 55 minus x, so both will be equal because this is also the total cost, this is also the total cost. Because if two pencils are made for 2 rupees, then 4 pencils will be of course 4 rupees. That is the thing we are discussing. It means the cost and when the number of toys will be multiplied, the resulting number will be the total cost, right? So let's solve it. 55x minus x square is equals to 750. 55x minus x square minus 750 is equals to 0. Or minus x square plus 55x minus 750 is equals to 0. We can again take minus as a common factor, right? So x square minus 55x plus 750 will be equal to 0, which is our required quadratic equation. This is how you can form quadratic equation with given information. Alright, let's move to the examples in which we will get to know the general form of a quadratic equation in a more simpler way. Now, this example onwards, we have to check that whether the given equations are quadratic or not. Right, so first equation is this. Now at a first glance, it's not looking like our general form, that is ax square plus bx plus c. But we can form it this way, but we have to simplify it a bit. So let's do a minus b whole square, that is a square plus b square minus 2ab plus 1 is equals to 2x minus 3. X square plus 4 minus 4x plus 1 is equals to 2x minus 3. Just solve it till it gets ended, like you cannot solve further, so just solve it till then. X square plus 4 minus 4x plus 1 minus 2x plus 3, because we need 0 on our right hand side. So x square 4 plus 1, that is 5, 5 plus 3, that is 8, minus 4x minus 2x, that is minus of 6x is equals to 0, or x square minus 6x plus 8 is equals to 0, or you can write x square plus of minus 6x plus of 8 is equals to 0. Now a is 1, b is minus 6 and c is 8, and it is of the same form of ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. That is why yes, it's a quadratic one, right? Let's move to the next part. This is our next equation, x plus 1 plus 8, x plus 2, x minus 2. Let's simplify it and see if it is becoming of the same form or not. X square plus because x will be multiplied, x square plus x plus 8 is equals to a plus b, a minus b, right? So a square minus b square. X square plus x plus 8 is equals to x square minus 4, or x square plus x plus 8 minus x square plus 4 is equals to 0. Now x square and x square will be cancelled, you will get x plus 12 only, which is not of the form ax square plus bx plus c. Now you can see that bx plus c is available here, but we cannot write 0x square, so that's why ax square is absent. Now why we cannot write ax square or is equal to 0x square? Because a can't be equal to 0 in a quadratic equation. This is the reason. That's why it's not a quadratic equation. Let's move to the next statement. This is our next statement. X 2x plus 3 is equals to x square plus 1. Let's see if it is a quadratic or not. 2x square plus 3x is equals to x square plus 1, right? Or 2x square plus 3x minus x square minus 1, because we need 0 on our right hand side. 2x square minus x square, that is x square plus 3x minus 1, which is clearly of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, where a is 1, b is 3, and c is minus 1. So yes, it is a quadratic equation. So now we are only left with our one part of the same exercise. So let's do that and finish our very first exercise. This is our last part of example second. In this, the equation is x plus 2 whole cube is equals to x cube minus 4. We have to solve the cube. So we have learned these kind of identities in 9th polynomials chapter, and the previous video was of polynomials chapter 9th class itself. So the link is given in description, and if anyone is not familiar with these kind of identities, he or she can go and watch that video first before coming back to this one. A plus b cube, that is a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube, right? What is the left hand side? That is x cube minus 4. Now x cube plus 6x square plus 3x multiplied by 4 plus 2 2s are 4, 2s are 8 is equals to x cube minus 4. X cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 8 is equals to x cube minus 4, or x cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 8. Now yes, you are guessing it right. We will take right hand side on the left one, because we need 0. Minus x cube plus 4 is equals to 0. X cube and x cube will be cancelled. You will only be left with 6x square plus 12x plus 8 plus 4, that is 12, is equals to 0. Now which is a common factor? Yeah, you are right, you can see it very clearly. X square plus 2x plus 2, because we have taken 6 as a common factor, right? So it is clearly of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, which means it is a quadratic equation. Now here, there is an interesting fact that when we had a very first look at the equation, it was like cubic equation. So some of you must be guessing that this is not going to be a quadratic equation anyway. But the thing is, when you will simplify it, you don't know that from where the terms get cancelled and you get a pure quadratic equation. So I would really say that don't underestimate a particular equation until or unless you completely solve it, alright? So this is how you can solve a given equation, and you can make or you can check that if it's a quadratic equation or not. Apart from that, you have also learned in this video that how to make a quadratic equation from a given situation, right? So I'm pretty much sure that you are now able to attempt all of the sums of your first exercise. If you find any doubt or any query related to any sum, kindly DM me on my Insta ID. The link will be given in the description for you guys. And also you can use the comment section to post your doubts. So keep practicing and don't forget to press the subscribe button before leaving my channel so that I can provide you with these kind of stuff on a regular basis. Alright, thanks for watching and keep watching my videos, keep supporting, and thanks once again. Happy practicing.